Bonjour. Hello.
Where do you come from?
I come from Holland, the Paiba.
I just arrived and I'm from Freiburg, near Black Forest area, and it's a 900 kilometers ride on the motorcycle. It took 3 days.
Hello, good evening. My name is Javier. I come from Las Palmas de Gran Canaria.
Holland, Netherlands, the Netherlands.
Where?
Amsterdam.
Germany, from the German juniors.
By car, by plane, by bus, by foot, etc., the aliens have taken over the small town of Fontenay-le-Comte. What do you think about here, Fontenay-le-Comte?
It's very nice, looks very nice.
I don't know, just arrived. Ask me later.
Nice town, tiny, so I checked it out. It's everything nice. No problem to find everything. The center, the fields, it's okay.
We haven't seen so much. We just arrived 2 hours ago.
Wherever they have come from, they must go to the headquarters to see the reception gang.
Okay, I already have this. Okay, Franca and Alexa already have their room in room 31.
To receive their cards, our artists need photographs. So the second checkpoint is the photo booth. Sweden juniors don't break this rule. From love, yeah, so I need your love, yeah, from love, yeah, I want your soul. Why are you like this on this photo?
Like this? Because we arrived so late tonight. We had some beer at the Paris airport. So we are pretty tired, all of us. So, but I don't think I look too bad.
Not too bad?
Yes, I do. But we are set to sleep tonight and I look better tomorrow.
Now that Father Christmas has given his presents to his children and we can get serious.
Good luck and see you in the finals.
This morning we had a game between the Finnish and the Austrian teams. The Austrian players started the game highly motivated, whilst the concentration of the Finnish was obvious.
Get push up! Yeah! Nice, keeper! Legs! Get up! Shit! Go long!
Donne! 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 Oi, che marcere! A me! Basta, via, Kini! Vai, va! Up! Up! Push up! Push up! And it's here!
The competition during the first points is very tough. Austria has to face a Finnish energy and organization.
Recht! Starting one!
Despite their determination, they will not succeed in keeping their scores close to the opponents.
Okay.
Harte!
puerto.
Ole, 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 jumalauta, muuvii nyt siellä. Mä meni on helppo ja laita!
Olli kattoo sua, Olli, Olli, hyvä!
21, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125
better score than 10-5. Just after halftime, Finnish will put a high level of pressure. Austrians won't come back in the game. They seem to have lost a part of their trust. Finland wins the game 19-11. Tomorrow, don't miss the training night, which will start at 9:30 in the gymnasium above the restaurant, and the video news carries on, so we are expecting you to discover and appreciate the most spectacular actions in the different games. See you tomorrow.
The very first game in this Euro 95 was the open division game opposing the Netherlands to France. The Dutch team scored the first point 3 minutes after the beginning. The Dutch are favorite. Nevertheless, the French managed to keep the score even to 3-3. Take the lead, scoring 5-3. They keep this advantage and work up to 10-4 lead at halftime. At halftime, the Dutch are confident, while the French are quite doubtful.
Les gars, pour moi, juste un mot, la confiance.
La confiance, voilà.
Okay, Michiel, Michael.
In the second half, the Dutch keep controlling the game, resulting in a final score of 19-10.
Oh,
They are 13, they come from the Canaries, and it's the first time that they have joined in a European championship.
Mi nombre es Loren, juego a frisbee in the beach, y tengo 38 años.
38.
38.
Hello, my name is Alexis. I'm from the Canary Islands, as you know. All the whole team, the whole Spanish team is coming from Gran Canaria. And I'm 31 years old. And I'm playing right on the middle of the... I'm the team right on the middle.
My name is Javier. I'm 32 years old. And I play ultimate in the middle, backwards. I'm glad to be here. Thanks for your help. Thanks for the advertising. And I'm very glad to be here. Thank you very much.
Good morning. My name is Thomas. I'm 35 years old. And that's the first time we come to play ultimates in a grass field. Used to play on the sandy beach, and that's all.
Hello, my name is Marco. I have 5. I from Spanish. I play ultimate in the
back.
In the back. You know, in the back.
My name is Francisco Gonzalez. I'm 31 years old. I play from the team.
My name is Guillermo with the Spanish team. And yeah, we play ultimate. A little because we play always in the beach, 1-1 or 2-2.
My name is Luis. I am 30 years old. I play frisbee in the beach.
My name is Roy. My name is Roy.
Rinde de inglés. Rinde.
I play from front. Okay.
Okay. My name is Javier. I am 33, and I play. I don't know where I play in the field.
My team is so funny. They are good players, but ultimate is another game. It's a new game for us, you know. We play frisbee. We play frisbee by the beach, you know. We never play frisbee. Coño, ultimate, you know. And this is really, really good to be here, you know. They love me. They love me so much, you know.
They are used to playing on beaches, and as far as freestyle is concerned, their game certainly lacks construction, but some progress can already be noticed.
The first time we played against a team, it was yesterday. And so we start. The first game they gave us 19-0, the second game it was 19-2, and this third game we're already 19-3. I hope by the end of the tournament, we can do much better, and we finally could make a few more points. I hope you don't laugh too much about us. We're trying our best, and I wish all the best to all the other teams from which we're learning a lot. Thank you.
Noble Soros should be informed that our Spanish friends are hooked on phoning. So if you have a few phone cards left, be generous. They have already got some out of Bugs and Raul.
Next time we hope to do better, because this is our first tournament, but it won't be the last.
I would like that everybody come to Las Palmas to see how it is and to try the Spanish banana. It's a very nice fruit. It's a very nice fruit.
Danger! Make sure your girlfriends stay close to you, very close.
He wants to meet some nice girls because he didn't see nice girls on this tournament. So
this is frisbee.
Girls think Alexis.
It's very important, the captain in the equipe.
As it's the first time these handsome Hidalgo have come to France.
They will steal them.
It's bound to happen.
Anyway, we thank them
a lot for coming.
Didn't you the bother?
The captain doesn't have a serious girlfriend. She doesn't have a serious boyfriend. Thank you.
was cold this morning on Le Plan des Sports for the match between the women's teams from the Netherlands and France. So cool that, for technical reasons, it was difficult for our cameras to wake up before the first half ended with a score of 9-3 to the Netherlands. Resumed, the French really hoped they would improve their score, but unfortunately they didn't succeed in overcoming the difficulties of playing in a strong wind, nor could they break the strict discipline of the Dutch and the way they used the field. The numerous throwaways and drops can certainly be explained by the difficult conditions. Consider the efficiency, the precision, and the speed of the Dutch, you'll easily understand why the match ended with an unappealing score.
Madam Parker from London, England, and I've come to cheer on the British team.
Mm-hmm. Are you parent of some players?
I am parent of one of the players, and she's 21 years old today, so I hope they're going to win their match.
What about Fontenelle Comte?
I don't know yet. Of course, I'm only playing, so I didn't went to the city. Sorry, ask me later.
Here comes the weather forecast for tomorrow. It will be pretty much the same as today, and with little sunshine, might rain in the afternoon, and the temperature is going to be below 22 degrees Celsius.
Tomorrow, don't miss the trading night, which will start at 9:30 in the gymnasium above the restaurant, and the video news carries on. So we are expecting you to discover and appreciate the most spectacular actions in the different games. See you tomorrow.
Too bad that many players partied too late yesterday night and therefore could not be able to wake up early enough to see the great game between the Finnish and the Swedish women. But luckily the video crew did it and was able to do it and film that game, a great game with speed, skill, techniques, fair play, beauty, dives, blocks, psycho D, everything you want to see in an ultimate game. The Swedish began at a very high level, too high for the Finnish girls. Done 4-0, the Finnish women scored one. Yeah, they did it, but couldn't stop the Swedish squad till 7-1. Sweden is now leading by 8-2, and luckily the Finnish women wake up at last and score several points in a row before halftime.
Royal Manchester!
Half time. Sweden is leading now 9-5. The girls try to stay in the game with the help of their supporters. No change during the second half. A nice game, and Sweden is still stronger than Finland, even if the game becomes broader. We expect both teams to reach semi-final. End of the game, one and a half. 17-9 for Sweden. Yay, but we do have to thank both teams, all these women, for such a nice show, and see you soon. Bye-bye.
On Monday night at the Plaine des Sports, the training took place.
Hello.
Je me retrouvais avec une tête de skinette.
Si ma mère me voyait.
Et je pars ressembler à un mec de Sergi.
Je dis, on va à la même réception avec le maire. Il n'y a pas de raison qu'on n'ait pas la même.
The match starts now. Time is running. Good luck.
The match between Finland and Germany, though not giving us any surprises in relation to the score, did give us a chance to appreciate the skills that both teams bring to the game. At 1-1, the Finnish side, taking advantage of the increased wind, started to play zone D. The German side showed their experience by remaining calm and patient. Through precise passing, they kept the Finnish Cup running and running.
Let's
Applying good teamwork, the Finns kept the Germans at bay during four consecutive zone points, allowing them very few penetrating passes. Playing against a man-to-man D, the Finns moved the disc with relative ease during this period, bringing the score to 5-1 in their favor. After a while, the Germans attempted to put a zone into effect. Through quick movement, the Finns never allowed the German cup to set up properly. The Finns take their biggest lead at 9-4. The Germans, attempting to come back, bring the score to 9-6. The Finns then take the half, 10-6. During the second half, the Finns stay on top by 4 or 5 points. This second half was highlighted by some solid D and the rare occurrence of a dropped pull. We'll be right back.
Chanson, on comprend rien quand tu l'achètes en anglais. Tu n'es pas rastafarien, tu chantes de le reggae. Ta chanson, on comprend rien quand tu l'achètes en anglais. Mets de l'huile. Mets de l'huile. Mets de l'huile. Mets de l'huile. Mets de l'huile, petit homme, dans la ville, faut que ça glisse. De l'huile, petit homme, écoute, écoute. Mets de l'huile, petit homme, dans la ville, faut que ça glisse. De l'huile, petit homme. Écoute, écoute, plutôt église, écoute, écoute.
What about Fontenay-le-Comte? Have you been downtown?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
No.
What do you think of it?
Well, ask me later.
Well, we have something for you.
What?
Look at this.
For Simon and all the other poor players who didn't have time to take advantage of the joys of tourism, here is a guided tour through Fontenay-le-Comte. Discover with us the fabulous Vendée Museum with its photos, old furniture, and its historical accounts.
In the Middle Ages, they used to build towers that, thanks to stairs, led to the buildings located near them. Owning a watchtower was a privilege.
Or, lorsque Richelieu, à la fin des guerres de religion, a voulu faire
But when Richelieu, at the end of the religion wars, decided to create an administrative and political unity for King Louis XIII's kingdom, he deprived the Protestants of such a privilege and asked them to lower their towers so that they were not higher than ordinary roofs.
Along the streets, you can admire the picturesque and varied fauna peculiar to the climate in Vendée. Fontenay, its church, green parks, alleys, bakers, its station, letterboxes, town hall, public benches, pavements, dustbins, kiosk, its cheerful contingent, bikes, its breathtaking relief.
Stop it! Shut up!
What do you find interesting in freestyle?
Well, I think it's funny, it's cool and all that. It's, you can show it to people on the beach. And
I love to do it because it's a good feeling.
It's like going up in the sky on the last goal in the World Championship final. Nothing is against. It's like it's you and the frisbee and God.
Have you been practicing for a long time?
Yeah, I started for 4 years ago, but I haven't practiced all the time, but a little bit here and there.
We started both for 10 years ago in the same club, but freestyle we've been playing, I don't know, together for 4 years, more or less.
Yes. I started with 13, but I stopped after. I didn't play for 4 years.
Do you invent your own positions or did you learn them?
I've learned them.
There's a lot to learn. I mean, you have to learn from others, because there are so many things in freestyle and almost everything has been done before. But we've done a couple new things, yes.
But it's always like a dream. You want to come up with something that's new and no one has ever done it before. And some old people will take after you and then you have your own move.
Yeah, the Thomas move.
The Thomas move, for example.
Welcome to the Masters Division with the second match, the Netherlands versus Germany. Germany pulls against the wind, but the Dutch drop the first pass and Germany gains possession of the disc. They try to score against the wind. In the first match, at the beginning of the tournament, the Netherlands beat Germany 17-15. So the audience could expect another close game. And eventually, Germany scores. After the downwind pull, Germany sets up a zone defense. And eventually gets the disc, throws it away again, gets it back. Throws it away again, gets it back, and scores. Our video crew has prepared this clip to show you just the highlights of the game. Here, bad luck for the Dutch, and Germany tries to set up a quick play again against the wind and scores to 3-0. With their wind in their back, Germany also scores the next point to 4-0. And with some luck, they get the fifth point and now have a comfortable lead, 5-0. When finally Yip of the Netherlands throws the score to the first point for the Netherlands. and with their wind in the back, score the second point. So the lead is only 3 point now. Here a short dispute. Goes back to the thrower. Swing and pass. Germany scores again. Franklin throws a score to 6-3 for the Netherlands. Here another short dispute, but Masters settle it quickly. Very short pass. And Germany hucks again with the wind in their back. And Martin lays it out to 7-3. Foul call by the thrower. Franklin scores for the Dutch. And another score, the Dutch closing in. Nice back block by Martin of Germany. The Dutch setting up a zone here. Do not succeed, and Germany scores 9-5. We are now in second half. Short pass and score for Germany. Sometimes hugging is part of the Masters play. Stack and score. Easy score for the Dutch. Once again, the Germans are trying to score against the wind. Nice grab by Steven. Long pass to the end zone. And here the final score, 17-10 for Germany.
Sonneur des lilas, le gars qu'on croise et qu'on ne regarde pas. Y a pas de soleil sous la terre, drôle de croisière. Pour tuer l'ennui, j'ai dans ma veste les extraits du Reader Digest. Et dans ce bouquin, il y a écrit que dégasse la coule douce à Miami. Pendant l'instant que je fais le zouave au fond de la cave. Paraît qu'il n'y a pas de saut métier, moi je fais des trous dans des billets. Je fais des trous, des petits trous, encore des petits trous. Des petits trous, des petits trous, toujours des petits trous. Des trous de saut.
Bonjour.
Allô, Samantha.
Alors mon nom c'est Thérèse.
Marie.
Bonjour, c'est Nathalie.
Yvonique.
Françoise.
Loïc.
Jacques.
Jacques.
Oui.
Jacques Chirac.
Non, non.
Non.
Bernard. Bernard Joly.
Bon nom, ça.
Hein?
Everybody be cool, this is a robbery.
Any of you fucking pricks move, and I'll execute every motherfucking last one of you.
Beetroots, and as main dish, ham from Vendée and some cup.
Du jambon de Vendée et du rôti de veau. Avec dessert,
c'est un éclair, deux bottes,
du fromage blanc ou des fruits.
There were great expectations for the first semi-final of the European Championships, a showdown between two of Europe's best teams. Would the outsiders, the Austrians, succeed as Germany had done in overcoming the Swedish supremacy? Or would the Swedes, the favorites and reigning champions, impose their game, their technique and their discipline? By the 8th minute, the Swedes suggest an answer to this question by taking a 3-1 advantage, increase their lead slowly but surely. In the 13th minute, they had a new point, bringing the score to 5-1. Despite several Austrian attempts, the Swedish machine works smoothly and efficiently and piles point upon point. In the 29th minute. The Austrians score a beautiful point in the 32nd minute, taking the score to 8-3. Straightforward point, the Swedes with the win at their backs, halftime is reached with a score of 11-5. In the second half, the Austrians raised their game by making tactical changes. For example, they organized themselves more intelligently against the wind. They succeeded in giving the Swedes some hard knocks and bring the score to 16-9 in the 53rd minute. Finally, the Swedish machine gets the better of the Austrians. Final victory 21-12, and the Swedish remain the favorites for the final.
Junior français en finale, c'est une surprise.
Oh, it's not really a surprise because I'm. Je te le fais en français en anglais.
Ben Flepintox.
Samuel Alligator.
David Flepintox.
Seb des Tourteaux.
Gérald Alligator.
Etienne Jacksons.
Moussa Blackstar.
Jeanne de Dalton.
Dan Sergitim.
Ukraine Sergitim.
Sam Flepintox.
Getu Sergitim.
JB pour le Sergitim.
Benoît Jackson.
Robert Blackstar.
Gaël Tourteaux.
The Junior's final game turned out to be a Swedish demonstration. Still, the qualification of the French juniors, beating Germany, was a quite unexpected performance. In order to follow them during their careful preparation for the final game against the Swedes, Video News first met their coach.
Jean-Marc, les juniors français en finale, c'est une surprise?
Une petite surprise, c'est vrai que c'était a priori avec les six équipes juniors qui étaient présentes face à nous, c'était faisable. Ils ont fait un gros match, ils ont très bien réagi au niveau moral. Donc c'est bien, c'est une belle récompense pour eux de faire cette finale. Les espoirs, et c'est ce que je leur dirais avant le match, de toute façon, c'est effectivement de se faire plaisir. Ils sont arrivés en finale. Maintenant, il faut qu'ils se fassent plaisir à jouer contre les Suédois, à les embêter.
Quelle sera leur préparation, leur mise en condition?
On ne va rien changer à ce qu'on fait d'habitude. On va simplement avoir en plus recours à Christian Gamori qui va les prendre un peu sur une petite séance de sophrologie avant pour les mettre bien dans le match. Autrement, on va refaire la petite séance de training avant, d'une heure, enchaîner les mêmes exercices, de rien changer aux habitudes.
On se voit faire cette action, il y a les tribunes, il y a du monde dedans. Hein.
Et on visualise le groupe là. Essayez de regarder vos copains là, de visualiser vos copains dans votre tête. C'est un groupe.
La séance de sophrologie, plus de détails.
Préparer la tête psychologiquement. Mettre son corps au diapason de son esprit. C'est concentration, anti-stress et confiance.
Of course, Video News also met the Swedish coach and his players.
I've been looking at France for a couple of games. We've been meeting them. I saw them against Germany in the semi-final, and I expect a tough game because I think they got skills. When we met them in the group play, I think they sort of were afraid of us because they heard that we were quite good, and so I think they can do much, much better in the final. My team is... We are trying to do our play. We don't look as much as we maybe should at the Frenchmen, because I think we got the skills that is necessary to win the final. So we play our game and let the Frenchmen do their play. So.
Well, my name is Edvard Engere, and I'm from Stenungsund in Sweden.
Well, my name is Erik Dahl, and I'm from Brunna Frisbee Club in Sweden, and this is my first international tournament.
My name is Henrik Sandin, and I'm from Sundsvall, Sweden.
Hello, my name is Jonas, and I'm from Brunna.
My name is Björn, and I'm from the club of Carnegie.
Hi, my name is Andreas Sjöberg, and I'm from...
Stenungsund.
My name is Christopher, and I'm from Carnegie Ultimate Disc Club.
Hello, my name is Daniel, I'm from Gävle Frisbee Disc Club.
Jesper Wichofors, Frisbee Club.
Stefan Akka, Frisbee Club.
Peter Sandin, Sundsvall Frisbee Club.
Martin, SFC Sweden.
Stefan, Växjö Ultimate Club.
Andreas from Stenungsunds Frisbee Club.
Fredrik from Stenungsunds Frisbee Club.
Jerker from Sundsvall.
After the surprising way realized by the French in this European Championship, the juniors offered to France their first participation to the ultimate final. Well done, young man, for your victory. The French juniors had to play against the Swedish, who are the king of ultimate, as you know. The lesson was difficult for them, but they had lots of fun, and they have certainly learned much since the beginning. After the fifth minute has gone, Sweden win 2-0. At the seventh minute, after a Swedish mistake, a well-done action permits to come back to 2-2-1. Sweden will accumulate some points after the first half-time.
at the 30th minute, the French will try to build a wall to have the Swedish wave stop, thanks to an action we'd have liked to see more often. The quality of the Swedish game will be completely expressed, leaving the young French without any real reaction. Attention, please. Be careful, ladies and gentlemen. Sweden is the European Ultimate Champion 95. Well done, the Swedish. A victory no one can contest. Thanks to you, French, and next time you'll be the best, sure. Oh, sorry. We, the young video crew, are glad to have spent all the week long with you, Ultimators, and we love you. See you soon next time. Ciao.
Hi, I'm Point pour la Suède.
Tuesday was the day of the match between the big-time favorite Sweden and one of the dark horses in this championship tournament, Finland. Both teams offer great strategic play and are brilliant to introduce some of the newest offense and defense systems seen in America. And here's the first fumble. Sweden drops the disc. And another fumble. Sweden is back into possession. I think both teams, they'll go to strengthen their position in the start of the game by playing tough defense and try to score the first goal.
Stop. Bara fem i tannet flyter. Det var Tommy.
Om jag ska skriva
så det är jag gett allt åt allt annat för det.
Närma dig!
Det var Tommy.
Sälen, du måste närma dig!
Finland playing zone defense, but here there was a great zone breaker upside down from the Swedish team. They moved up halfway the field. And another fumble. Great block from Finland. Sweden and Finland have met many times in the past. Sweden taking five or six European titles straight, and meeting Finland in many of the final games, maybe even all of them, I can't remember. Finland has an ongoing contest with the Boston team from USA about who is the best team in the world at being second best. Finland claiming to have the title because they've lost so many times to Sweden, and Boston for losing many national championships and world titles to New York. There's been ongoing discussions about having a game set up who should decide who is best at being second best, but it has stranded on the problem if whether the winner or the loser should be the best at being second best. And a brilliant inside out pass, and Sweden scores another point. I think there's a strip call. The Finnish guy, the Finnish number two, claims that he caught the disc before it was taken out of his hand, and the disc goes back. The Finnish team is a mixture between old and new players, with five or six players on the team playing their first international tournament, and then also five or six players who have been in the game for many, many years. Two of them had their 150th national game yesterday and celebrated it. And I think they hope that they can come up with a victory, so the celebration will be perfect.
Järjellä, järjellä. Nyt on
Quality of the game is much lower than one could expect from a game between Finland and Sweden, and it seems to be that both teams are very, very nervous here in the beginning and wants to control the game, but neither of them has the nerve to do it. The score is still 2-1, and we've had like 10 or 15 fumbles already or bad passes, and I think it's time for both teams to strengthen their game a little bit, and here we see Sweden score to 3-1. And there goes another one. Sweden 4, Finland 2. That the winner of this game will be in first position, so the semi-final game will be a little easier. The Swedes have already beaten Holland, and Finland has already beaten Germany, and these might be the top four teams in this tournament. And I think in general one can say, and here we have a long pass for Finland, and scored just outside the end zone, and here's the score, 5-Sweden, Finland 3. It seems to me like the top ultimate teams in Europe are moving a little closer together as time goes. Both Holland and Germany and many other countries are moving closer to Sweden. Finland maybe not at the moment. I think it would be good for the game of ultimate here in Europe if there would be many teams at this championship tournament in the future. They could play very even games and promote the sport. The addition of night games that we haven't seen early in European Championship tournaments have been invented by the organizers because they felt that the night games could be a good way to promote the sport and to show games when the spectators are not working. That means that what we have seen in the past, that we play during daytime And then in the evening, where we could have spectators, there have been no games. Here, the tournament has sort of been planned to attend spectators more than we've seen earlier. And also the games, they have been picked to show different nations and both men's and women and masters games. So we present the sport as the variety of game types that we have in Ultimate. I think this is a great idea, and I hope that it could be introduced to other top tournaments in the future. Here we have Finland scoring again against the Swedish man-to-man defense, and they are now tying up the gap. So it's Sweden 5, Finland 4. And Timo Vaskio makes the pull. There's a brick call, the disc landed outside. It's hard to find the brick spot, so it's being measured. The Swedes have gained more control over their offense now, and it seems like they have an easier way to complete their passes than the Finns they have. They are more open when they cut, and it might be a matter of time before they score the next goal. And another foul call, but it seems like both teams, they are interested in getting the game going. There's not that much discussion. And a little risky sidearm, and there's a turnover. And the Swedish player calls a foul on himself, and Finland calls a timeout. We are back in the game, and Finland, they go for the long one, and they are just outside the end zone, and now it's about converting, and here it is. A bit lucky. And Finland has finally tied the game at 5-5, and are ready to go for defense. And here we have a zone defense system where there's one guy marking on the field with his back to the thrower, watching for the upfield cut. Just behind the cup of three players, we have an extra man who's supposed to poach or to stop for poppers. Throws coming through the zone. Here we have one. And Here the Swedish players, they lost their patience and is punished with their turnover in their own end zone. And now we have to see how Finland, they convert, how they convert this opportunity to get a lead in the game. And they play the banana split on Moses, where the four front players, they cut away from the middle of the stack, and one of the back players goes right through the middle and gets the disc wide open. Finland is now in offense and goes for another long one. And that's an easy one. Man is wide open. And Sweden 6, Finland 7. Seems like Finland is now playing man-to-man defense again. I think after a start with a lot of fumbles, the quality of the game has improved a lot. And both teams are getting more control of the game. And here Sweden goes for another one, and that's an easy one too. 7-7. Many teams uses this tournament as an opportunity to get new players involved in national team play and preparing for the World Championships 1996 in Sweden. As far as I can see, also on the Swedish team, there are quite a few new players, and of course it leads to misunderstandings once in a while, and especially in this game with two teams that have met each other so many times and played so many close games and always wants, maybe more than they want to beat any other team, want to beat each other. Well, of course anyone would like to beat the Americans. And it's a little too high, and it's out.
Thank you.
There goes the long sidearm, and it's out of bounds. Sweden has the advantage of being a member of the Swedish National Sports Council, Riksidrottsförbundet, which support them with funds for information and for national team practice and for whatever they want to spend them on. That means that in opposition to many other countries, they actually have a way to pay for their expenses for these tournaments and to have regular practice session where the best team players of the country meet and practice together. Finland is a member or an associated member of their National Sports Council, which also give them few funds. And as something quite new, Denmark has become a member of the National Sports Association, and this could be a help for Denmark, who has not been able to send a team to France. Also, the British Ultimate Federation works to get into the National Sports Council, and I think that many other teams would be quite happy if it's the same could happen to them, and they could get more financial support to play Ultimate.